Therapy Thursday, now on Wild 94.1.
I understand therapy.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Dr. Nick.
It's Therapy Thursday, where we give our lean towards the mental health professionals out there and do our community service. This is where we give you 60-second sessions of brilliance. That's all we can really pull off. Fake it or flaws. We just pretty much make it happen. Mm-hmm. And you can hit us up 888-429-0941, whether it's Dr. Davi, Meredith MD, Orlando BGYN. We will give you the best business we can. Let's see here. We actually got a call in. Meredith MD, you in? You taking calls yet?
I'm ready.
All right. Let's see. Taylor is on the phone. Hey, Taylor. How you doing?
Hi, guys. First time caller.
Hey, first time caller. First time caller.
Welcome to the Freak Show, Taylor. Let's see. You are on with Meredith MD. What is your question for Therapy Thursday?
Hi, Meredith. So I've been trying to get pregnant for a long time, and I'm about 10 weeks right now. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to be excited, but I'm absolutely miserable, and I'm trying not to show everybody that I'm miserable. So
why are you miserable?
What do I do? I'm getting sick all the time. I'm exhausted. I'm crying all the time.
Oh, all those hormones, they hit you every single second of every day, especially in the first trimester. Have you told everybody, obviously, that you're pregnant yet?
I've told my family and my coworkers, and they're all, you know, trying to tell me that pregnancy is a miracle and everything's great, but I'm miserable.
I gotcha. Okay. So, yes, you're miserable now, but within the next 3 weeks, maybe 4 weeks or sooner, it's really going to get better. The second trimester, I've done this before, you get all your energy back. You're not falling asleep in your car anymore. Cause I remember I would try to go to the gym legit on our work break. And I would try to go to the gym and I would just pass out in my car.
She'd be right there in the car sleeping.
Sleeping. And it would happen to me all the time, trying not to throw up. So listen, take it day by day. You're doing a great job. You're doing amazing. What your body is going through, it's making you suffer so the baby can have all that beautiful effort and grow. So it's making you sick, but within the next couple of weeks, you're going to feel so much better. Seriously, you will. The second trimester is fantastic. Now, the end of the third trimester, that's when you'll start to feel bad again. But just get through this rough patch. I'm telling you, you'll see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Can I ask Taylor a question real quick? Taylor, do you think, you mentioned that you tried to get pregnant for a long time. Do you think maybe there's a sense of not believing it or you don't want to get your hopes up? Do you think there's a sense of that going on with you?
Definitely.
Maybe that could be part of it, too.
It's more like you're depressed maybe about certain situations that have happened in the past, and then you're feeling sick, so it kind of combines together. You're not really feeling that good right now.
Well, Taylor.
Yeah, it's like I'm trying to be not scared, but I'm like, hey, this is the miracle, you know?
Well, you know what, though? And don't even make it so unpersonal, like just as far as the miracle. You know, this is what you've been looking for, and just think somebody is going to call you mom. Yep. Somebody is going to benefit. Your relationship with them is going to be beneficial from this whole struggle that you're going through. So this is that part that you have to, like, dig down and say, this is for me fighting for my kid. And keep your mentality strong, because during this time you can fall into a depression, and that's a rough part of it. So the keeping positive is a plus.
It's worth the pain and the struggle, because you'll look back on this and be like, oh my gosh, that happened so fast. But when you're in it, it feels like it lasts such a long time.
Forever.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you'll be good, Taylor. You're doing just as well as everybody else will be doing. So don't think you're being different, okay?
Okay, thanks, guys.
You're doing a great job.
All right, girl, get going. That's what's up.
It's tough. Pregnancy sucks sometimes.
We got one for you, Orlando, out of the 727. It says, Orlando, my question for Therapy Thursday is, how do you feel about / manage your daughters and social media?
Let's see. I don't manage it. Their mom does that, and she pretty much does. I mean, it started with them not really being aware of it, and she just kind of handled everything and put managed by mom type on thing on there.
Yeah, that's good.
And now it's pretty much just for the people who reach out to them professionally or for like dance or something like that. Then they know to reach out to their mom. But they have friends who have Instagram and stuff, and their friends write, and they write them back, and that's being able to be monitored by their mom too. So I kind of trust her with it. I don't look at their monitoring as much because their mom is monitoring it. So if I see something that's posted, nine times out of 10, she's posted it.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't reach out and have to say, hey, take that down, or hey, I don't feel that, because I know it came from their mom. Same way, if I post up something and my daughter likes it, I'm like, I don't know if my daughter liked it. That's probably their mom,
mm-hmm.
you know, because she controls it. So it's not an extension of the kid yet if you have somebody managing it and handling it. And I will say it's people are pensive about doing it. But I know Carlos Diaz, who used to do Extra at 8 with us and all-time, long-time friend of the show, he has launched Instagram pages for his son Dacio, because his son Dacio is killing it at golf right now, and he's able to be marketed by golf companies and stuff, so they needed a hub of all of his videos. So it's not bad to do it. It's not bad at all.
Just be cautious.
Be cautious.
For
that's
sure.
All. That's all. Who is this? What is this? It says we need to do a segment. What is this?
Oh, yeah. We have a woman on the phone that...
You want us to do a segment? What is that?
A segment where you call deadbeat dads and you ask them why they're being deadbeat dads to their children.
Like call them on the phone?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
And ask them why they're being deadbeat?
I'm about to call my ex-husband right now. Well, he's still my husband, but literally my son just went to the house and knocked on the door where he lived at with his 30-year-old girlfriend who he cheated on me with. And he wouldn't even answer the door for our son. And it makes me want to kick the door in and just cause havoc.
And you're sure he's at the house?
Oh, I'm positive he's at the house. He doesn't go to work until later. His car is there. He's there.
So he's just not answering with his kid knocking?
Wow.
Yep.
Wow.
And he filed a motion yesterday with the court saying that I won't give him shared parenting time because I won't let our kid sleep over at his girlfriend's apartment, which every day, and I have thousands of text messages saying... Every single day, do you want to see your kids? Do you want to take the kid? I'm that different mom. I want him to be a father. I don't care about the money.
Mm.
I'm like the exception to the rule. Be a dad. I don't want our kids to be a statistic. I don't want our kids to grow up having issues. Mm. I want you to be an active dad. And our son's knocking on the door at 8:30 in the morning and you're not answering the door? What the Who does that? Literally, who does that?
No, that I mean, that's heartbreaker right there. I'm sorry.
She's been
I'm
dealing with this for a while.
That's frustrating. I'm sorry. That's embarrassment. That's embarrassing for...
This woman is 30, has no kids, offers him nothing, and here I am, 46 years old. I have everything. I gave birth to our twins 12 years ago and even had a heart attack and died during the delivery of our twins. I literally passed away and was on life support for 2 days and in the hospital for 2 weeks in ICU to give birth to our twins. And then after that, they cut my kidney and I had to get kidney repair 17 months later. So this is my life and the things that I would do for my children a million times over. And I can't even get you to answer the door when our 12-year-old's knocking on the door to talk to you before he goes to the gym with his mother. Like, really? Like, that's so heartbreaking for our kids.
No, that is. I mean, you would hope that, you know, whatever he is going through or whatever shortcoming is going to be like a phase, like, I mean, something that he can grow out of and get out of it fast enough to be effective in his kid's life, because not answering the door is going to leave an impression that's going to stick with him for a while. So he's got some time to correct it, but he's got to get on the right side of it soon. So, I mean, the lucky part is that your son has you and more as a constant for him. And that's an incredible thing, because if your father or your one parent is falling short, having somebody who can be there for him on the other side is a great compensation. So at least be proud of that.
He's never been a good father. He has an 18-year-old daughter who I raised, and now he wants to be a dad that she's 18 in the Army. Now he's a dad because he doesn't have to be a dad anymore. He doesn't have to be a parent. He doesn't have to pay child support or give her any emotional support. She's 18 and she's in the Army. He just has to answer the phone and be like, oh, I have a daughter in the Army. Look at me wearing my cool shirt. You know, which he had nothing to do with. That was me. Mm. That was all me. And you can't have a good relationship with an ex, because I was married before, and my first ex-husband and I are best friends. His wife and I are best friends. We go on vacations together. We stay at each other's homes. I'm from New Jersey originally. I go to Jersey. I stay there. They come here. They stay with us. So you can have a good, healthy relationship with somebody that used to be in a relationship with and have children with. It's possible.
I hear you. Absolutely. I agree.
You date somebody that's younger and has no kids. That's the thing. She has no children and does not. She comes from a broken family as well. She doesn't have a good relationship with her father at all. And that baffles me too, because I'm a female. My father's my best friend. I can't imagine not having a relationship with my dad, or a woman not having a relationship with their father. to me, you got to be the lowest form of life if you have a good parent and you don't have the relationship with them. That's just my opinion. Because there's nothing I couldn't do that my dad would ever stop talking to me. Literally nothing.
Well, I hope it gets better.
Yeah. I mean, you know, all this is really good ammunition to, you know, like I said, be able to be that effective parent. So that's an awesome thing. So
really hard.
I'm sure it is. But just keep doing what you're doing. And, you know, that's what you can control. Hopefully he catches up to your greatness. All right. So I do appreciate you checking in. I hope, you know, we put at least a little perspective on it, or at least let you get it out a little bit, you know. It's Therapy Thursday, so we want to try and help as many people as possible. But yeah, we can't air him out like you wanted, but I think karma's going to air him out in the long run, okay?
I hope so. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it.
No problem.
All right.
Kids are lucky to have her.
I got some more therapy for y'all if y'all ready to keep killing it.
We can keep therapying.
You keep ready. Yeah, this one is fine. For Meredith or O.
All right, take it, Meredith.
You ready?
Okay. I just took Mama Yum Yum talk over here.
Okay,
all right, here we go. It says, I am a bisexual man that is basically being forced into a heterosexual relationship.
Who's forcing you?
Because I have a kid. Oh. I am not happy. She is always mad about something. I lean more towards men because the vibe is better, but I love kids and I want more. I am so torn.
There's different options for you. You can be with a man and adopt. I mean, there's plenty of options out there for you. If you don't like being with a woman, you don't have to be with a woman. You will have to associate with a woman in the future because you have a kid with one.
Yeah, so, you got at least 18 years.
Hey, exactly. And by the way, I mean, try to make that relationship as sweet as possible. And I know it's
very
difficult.
Sweet.
It's
very sweet.
It's difficult because you're dealing with, I don't know, a lot of issues at the moment. But because
you ain't a man.
But you, she can't grow that part on her. So go find somebody that makes you happy, if whether you're bisexual or not. If you're with somebody that doesn't make you happy, you don't have to be stuck in that relationship. You're not. It doesn't sound like they're married. You know, you can make sure the kid's taken care of, make sure she's okay, but go and live your life. Go find a man that you want to be with.
Yeah, you can't force yourself
Who's
into that situation, for real.
Yeah,
that's never going to work out or whatever.
Be
true to yourself.
Ah, that was record timing right there. Yeah.
I mean, that's kind of, once you say that and you ain't on that team no more, it's kind of limited on what you can say.
Yeah,
well,
he's close.
On both teams.
Well, I mean, not really.
He said,
I'm done. I'm ready to tap out and move over.
He said, I am a bisexual man.
Right.
He didn't say I'm a gay man.
But he's a bisexual man.
That doesn't want to be with women.
That don't
want to
be the woman no more
I think the problem is the woman that he's with. I think it's her.
Maybe it's easy for him to be with a guy right now. Try that. Who knows?
Wow. All right. Let's see here. We got Joe on the line. Joe, you got Dr. Davi. What you got?
Good morning, guys. How y'all doing?
We're doing good. Hey. Joe, what's good?
Man, 100-time caller, 100-time caller. Listen, I need a little therapy action on this Thursday. Okay, so we got masks on, right?
Yeah.
Everybody's wearing masks, and, you know, you don't want no spittle going this way, whatever, whatever. How about when it comes to getting down and dirty with the SEX? Like, people ain't, you know, worried about putting their mouths other way, but you want to put your mouth behind a mask.
That's true.
That's all good.
You can't casually date out there in this world and be swatted. Yeah. You can't be exchanging fluids that way.
Okay, so what do you tell the chicks? Oh, you a single man. You got something like myself. What do you tell them when they want you to come through and bless them? How do you tell them no? How do you tell them I still like you, I still love you, whatever the case may be? But I ain't coming through right now. without losing them. You know what I'm saying? Without losing them. Because if you don't show a woman affection, they kind of, you know, stretches
away.
Mad.
Yeah, they do. They do. That Dr. Davi, what you got?
Okay, so I think there's a lot here. One of the main things is be careful. And if you're just kind of with, like, one person, then you're pretty much being careful. You know what they've been doing. I don't think abstinence is what we're calling for. I think it's...
Davi's against that.
Yeah, I'm against abstinence.
He is totally against abstinence.
But I think now more than ever is the time to be cautious, really protect yourself. And like, I wouldn't be on Tinder swiping right now if I was like, you know what I'm saying? I don't think right now is the time to be like extra promiscuous. So if there was ever like cuffing season, I think Corona is bringing like its own version of cuffing season. You find that one or maybe two people that you can have in,
no,
in your rotation.
No, you just messed it up, doctor.
No, wow.
I mean, we're being realistic.
Your lab
here.
Coat is getting smudged.
You gotta know your audience.
Let the doctor speak.
So I think now is the time to be very limited with your interactions with people. Be careful. Do your due diligence. Don't stop altogether. But like, you know.
Two of them.
Just add,
how are you being careful with two chicks?
Don't do more than two.
Meredith, be quiet. Joe is listening.
Meredith, this is not your appointment.
Just asking.
Thank you very much. Much love, y'all.
We got you, Joe.
Appreciate you, Joe, man.
You just got to keep it real with the people, Meredith.
Okay, with the peeps?
With the people.
I mean,
okay.
But you know what, though? It is true, because you having one person is cool, but you have to unequivocally know what that person is into.
Right.
If they still dating their ex-boyfriend.
Right.
And their ex-boyfriend got a new girlfriend.
And she dating two people.
And she work at a germy massage parlor or something. The whole pathogen control, the
yeah.
The whole transfer.
Just share,
it'll make it to you.
Share one gross person.
He's talking about two.
I know, it's two.
But I'm saying,
Mr. Pandemic over here.
If you were like, if you had a bigger rotation, if you had like a 10-person rotation.
You don't, cut it not off. In the Rona.
But that's what I'm saying. Back in the day. So now you can't go from that, you know, that big squad to one.
Damn, we said back in the day and that was like 4 months
that's
ago.
That's what I'm saying.
That's
yeah,
sad.
4 months
just
ago.
Be realistic.
4 months ago, you could have had a team. You can't do that now. Therapy Thursday is a wrap, people.
Commercial free me.